Do you know there are five essential substances that are vital to our survival? Our bodies will become imbalanced if any one of those are deficient. Hello, Alex here. Today I'm going to be talking about the five essential substances in our bodies. These substances nurture our body and make sure our bodies are in balance. The five substances are qi, essence, blood, body fluid, and shen. Now, let's discuss each substance one by one. First of all, qi. I have explained qi in the last episode. If you didn't get a chance to take a look at it yet, please click the link here. In summary, qi is an invisible energy that drives everything in the universe. Secondly, essence. Qi and essence is a yin and yang pair. Qi is an invisible energy that is constantly moving. Therefore, it is yang. While essence is visible and purely substantial, therefore, it is yin. Essence is the material foundation of life. There are three types of essence: prenatal essence, postnatal essence, and reproductive essence. The prenatal essence of a person originates from the combined essence of the parents. It is inborn and it serves as the basic substance that helps in the constructing of the body and initiating life activities. The postnatal essence is acquired from the food nutrients after digestion. It is distributed to all parts of the body and supports the growth, development, and maintenance of the body. The reproductive essence is a substance that allows us to produce offsprings. Thirdly, blood. Blood is composed of nutrients from food and body fluid. It is important to note that the blood in Chinese medicine is different from that of Western medicine. In Chinese medicine, the blood is not only responsible for carrying the nutrients to nourish all parts of the body. It is also an essential substance for the mental activities. Any deficiency in blood will have an effect on emotions. Fourthly, body fluids. Body fluids are all liquids in our body other than blood, and that includes saliva, mucus, urine, sweat, and etc. Body fluids are originated from the water and food intake, and it is excreted in the form of sweat, urine, and feces. The main function of body fluid is to moisten, lubricate, and nourish all parts of the body. It is also an important component of blood. Lastly, shen. Shen is often translated as spirit or mind. However, those two terms still couldn't really capture what exactly is shen. Shen is a very broad term that covers consciousness, thoughts, emotions, senses, and it also covers the physical and mental outer manifestation of a person. Understanding the five substances is important for diagnosis and treatment. For example, if one patient is experiencing dizziness, pale complexion, dry skin, blurred vision, numbness of the limbs, then Chinese doctors will usually diagnose this as blood deficiency, and then they will prescribe herbs and do acupuncture that can promote the production of blood. Therefore, it is important to differentiate which substance is in imbalance and then do the treatments accordingly. Thanks for watching today. In the future, I will be talking about the disorders of the five essential substances, how to cure and prevent them. In the next three videos, I will be talking about the internal organ systems in Chinese medicine. If you would like to learn more about Chinese medicine, make sure you hit the subscribe button and stay tuned. I will see you in the next video.